So dear students, today we are going to start the new topic, or we can call it new chapter, that is fraction and decimal. This chapter in a very huge content we have studied in class 6, where fraction chapter was different and decimal chapter was different, but here both are combined. So let us study first about fractions and then we'll come to know about decimals. Now always remember that fraction is a part of whole. Fraction is a part of whole. So whenever you have anything in complete position, okay, and you are making some part of it, okay, whatever you talk about, it's about a chapati, eatable thing, or any kind of work. Like if you have to complete a maths copy, okay, and there are so many pages in your maths copy which you have to complete the work. But you are not able to complete all the pages at a time. So suppose half of the page you have done it and half of the page your sister has done it for you. So that is again the fraction again. So whenever you have any complete thing to do and you are doing that particular thing in a part, okay, something you do it, something another will do it. So that, there the concept comes of fraction. Whether you talk about pizza, whenever you are eating, suppose one part, somebody else is eating two parts, this is again a fraction only. When you have a full glass of water, little bit you drink and leftover you just give to the plant, this is again fraction. Okay, in a bus there are so many people sitting and traveling, there some fraction of part, some part of the people or passengers are female, rest are male and children, that is again fraction. So whenever any of the complete thing you have and usme parts agar divide ho jate hain, there the concept comes of fraction. So remember, fraction is a part of whole. Now remember, if you talk about fraction, fraction can always be written in the form of t by q. T by q means where t is numerator and q is denominator, okay, where q is not equal to zero. Denominator should not be zero anytime, okay, denominator cannot be zero. And one more very important concept, that p and q both should be only natural numbers. Only natural numbers, it means all positive, no negative. Now can you tell me, on the basis of this information which I have given you just now, can you please tell me zero is a fraction or not? Answer in the chat box. Now look at here. Yes, you have to write down everything in your copy. Now here, if you talk about zero, zero can be written as the form of 0 by 1. And if I am asking from you that zero is a fraction or not, you simply see that this, it is p, this is q, okay, and p and q should be natural number only. But q is a natural number, but p is not a natural number in case of zero. So that is why zero is not a fraction. Yes, now we are discussing about unit fraction. Now unit fraction, whenever you take one part of whole, only one part of whole, it means you are talking about unit fraction. For example, 5 may say one part, 7 may say one part, 8 may say one part, 11 may say one part. These all are unit fractions examples, okay, where the numerator is 1, okay, or in another language you can also call this, then you can also say this, like in when you take one part of any whole, then it means you are talking about unit fraction. So here these are the types of fraction I can call, okay. One by one let us know about. First, like fraction. Like fraction means जब आप एक ही पार्ट के, ठीक है, एक ही पार्ट के लाइक एक ही होल के डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पार्ट्स लेते हो, देन यू कॉल इट लाइक फ्रैक्शन. और यू कैन ऑल्सो कॉल दैट द डिनोमिनेटर इज सेम इन लाइक फ्रैक्शन केस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 5 पार्ट में से 2, 5 पार्ट में से 1, 5 पार्ट में से 3, 5 पार्ट में से 5. These all are like fractions. ठीक है, these all are like fractions where denominator is same in all the cases. ठीक है, all parts are taken from the same whole. 5 वाले whole में से ही सारा कुछ लिया गया है. ठीक है, so these are all like fractions. Now unlike fraction, when they are the part of different wholes. For example, 1/7, 3/8, 5/11. Where the denominators are different in each case, okay? Where the denominators are different in each case, then we call it unlike fraction. Now the same thing come on proper fraction. Proper fractions are the fraction where denominator is greater. Okay, denominator is greater than numerator. Then it means you're talking about proper fraction. For example, 3/5, 8/11, 7/19. Here, remember, it is in this one, denominator is greater than numerator. But when you talk about improper mein just opposite beta. Numerator is greater than denominator, like 15/7, 11/2. These all are the example of improper fractions. And improper fraction mein kya hota hai beta? Denominator chota ho jata hai. And who is greater here now? Numerator is greater. Denominator will be smaller and numerator will be greater in this case. Now let's move on to mixed fraction. Mixed fraction comes from the improper only beta. Mixed fraction are coming from improper only. हम improper fraction को mixed के form में कभी भी लिख सकते हैं, ठीक है? So mixed is the combination of whole number and the form of fraction also. तो वो part भी होता है उसमें और whole number भी होता है. For example, 3 whole 1/2. Now see, whole is also there and part is also there. So this is called mixed one. 7 whole 2/5. 3 whole 2/11. These all are mixed fractions. So this we have written in the, yes. So remember, proper fractions are always less than one. Hamesha one whole se chote hote hain beta. All the proper fractions are less than one. And all the improper fractions are greater than one. And same, क्योंकि मैंने आपको बताया ही पहले से कि बेटा improper से ही mix जाता है, है ना? Improper से ही mix जाता है. So it means improper हो या mixed हो, both are greater than one. Finished. ठीक है, नाउ जस्ट अ क्विक फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स एंड आफ्टर दैट आई विल एंड अप द क्लास. ठीक है, जस्ट अ क्विक फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. आई एम राइटिंग ओवर हियर व्हिच यू विल डू इट. 3/5, द साइन ऑफ कंपैरिजन यू हैव टू पुट. हाँ,
ma'am, we have to answer in the chat.
No beta, directly in your copy. Sorry, it's all fatty hai. Look at here now, this is a proper fraction, so it is already told that one will be greater over here. Then 2 whole 3/7, yahan pe pehle se dikh raha hai beta that this is whole, aur yahan par one whole hai, yahan pe two whole hai, to zahir si baat hai this one will be greater. Theek hai. And this one is again improper, and improper is always greater than one. So again, this one will be there. and the last one 7/7. It will cancel, which will give you 1, and 1 is equal to 1. So finished.